very interested in hearing from you. Okay, take it away.
Okay, how was everybody? So I don't expect the world to happen here, but it's not going to happen. Let me just start off by saying it's a little weird for me being here because I just found out my father graduated from this school. Because I was originally born in Milwaukee, New Jersey. And the best part about looking at everybody out there in the crowd, to be honest with you, is a lot of you guys are of different nationalities. A lot of you guys are different. I'm guessing most of your parents are foreigners. Is that correct? No. How many of you guys speak two languages?
Just so that I could have a better life.
That's not what she loves. So I had to sit there and tell myself, if she's going to give me that kind of dedication, it's my responsibility, my job, to make sure that she didn't give me up everything in her life for no reason. So every day I still say I got to be proud, and I got to be my mother proud. People took care of me and raised me. So I got in the corner. I started doing cooking, and I fell in love with it. It became a passion. The beauty of having a passion is you'll never spend one day of your life, if you guys find something that you love to do, you'll never work one day in your life. Ever. Because it's not work when you love it. You won't dread getting up in the morning. You won't dread working 12 hours if you have to. You'll just love it. Believe me, I know. I work 14 hours a day. Today's my one day off this week. I average 80 hours a week. That's how many hours I put in every week. And I have been working very, very hard to make sure, because my dream is to make sure everybody here knows my name. Before I die and pass in this world, I want to make sure the world knows who I am and I become a legacy. That's my goal in life. And I want to do it through food. Because my family is all about food, tradition. Not everybody here speaks two languages, but you all are some kind of nationality. Everybody's different. Everybody's nationality will change because, for example, the little girl over here looking at me, you'll sit there one day, you may marry an Irish guy. And then all of a sudden, you don't speak Spanish to your daughter or your son, because he doesn't. First thing that always goes in your culture is your language. The one thing that never goes away is the food. You can find Spanish food, Italian food, Irish food, Jewish food, anything in the world, everywhere. Because what I do for a living is the greatest career in existence. That's how I feel about it. And the reason why I can tell you that is, not one of you is in this room, teachers, anybody. Nobody has ever had an experience in life without a chef being a part of it. I'm there for your first date to make that happy and special moment for you. I'm there for your wedding. I'm also going to be there for our room and have lost a loved one, our next place, everything. You'll never find anybody that's ever done anything without a chef being a part of their life. So I create dreams. I sit there and make memories for people. Memories that they will never forget. Ones that pass down from generation to generation. Because I love that much of what I do. I sat here when they told me that I couldn't type. Because being dyslexic, I had issues typing. I had to look at a keyboard. Teachers would yell at me. Don't look at keys. You're supposed to memorize it. Well, I can't do that. So, back in the day when we had typewriters, because the internet did not exist when I was in high school, that didn't come into my 20s. You guys have a lot easier because you have modern technology that helps spell things out for you. You guys have Dragon. You guys have Uber, Spellcheck, all those things, which makes it a little easier. Now, when I'm talking about my disability, how many people here are classified?
I don't
know. Raise your hand, be proud of it. Just wait your hand on the telling show. You're a classified student? There's gotta be a lot more here. You guys are a little embarrassed right now.
Anton, IEP. Don't know that.
Huh?
Who has an IEP?
Oh, I thought you guys referred to it as an IEP.
Yeah.
Who has an IEP? Sorry. I was false. Resource rooms and classified. That's what it was when I was a kid. And out of everybody who's got their hands up, how many of you guys play sports? Are you a good athlete over here? Yes. Are you a good athlete? You are. Are you obsessed with it? Are you obsessed?
Do you love it?
Like, it's based on you love it. It's based on your life. It is. Everything about it. So that's one of the beauties of being dyslexic or a comprehension deficit order. When you find something you're good at, you become obsessed where you want to do it all the time. And because you're good, you want to be perfect. Because that's where you'll shine in life. Which is part of what I do in my degree. So if he can make it to baseball, he will be happy. But like I said, if he doesn't, something ever happens and that dream ends, doesn't mean it's over. He can become a coach. He can be a coach one day here in this school. I mean, I went to a tech school, Georgetown Tech, because I was inside the program, and I hang him up sitting there in my culinary degree for the first time, 2 year culinary. And now I'm allowed to come in and teach kids how to cook. Who would have thought somebody like me could have been a teacher one day? I'll probably do it when I'm ready to retire, because it's a lot easier. No offense to anyone else. Then, after doing all those little special things that I've done in my life and realizing what my family sacrificed for me and everything else, I've just been on a mission ever since.
I'm going to bother you. You need to walk out.
A little more, yeah.
Why?
Lower the mic.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good. You guys can't see me?
Yeah.
Anyway, where was I? Yes. See what my family and everybody sat there and they sacrificed for me, so now I know it's my job, my responsibility, and I'm going to be going forward. So I actually started talking to some people and surrounded myself with people who are more intelligent than me. Because the best part about that is you learn more. You'll learn from other people and watch what they do, and you'll learn from your mistakes. Some of the biggest mistakes in my life was being a failure in certain things. I opened up my first restaurant when I was 23. Right here in Edgewater. Anybody here from Edgewater? Well, Route 5 on the bottom right over there.
That's
right. My apple's warm. I used to be Pizza on the Edge. That was mine. It used to be Antonio's Pizza, Pasta and Warm, back in 1998. And I sold that in 98. Because Edgewater went through a whole thing. Anyway, you don't really care about that. So when I did that when I was 23, and I thought I was a failure, that made me wrong. Maybe have more desire to be successful. So then I sat there, and after having my little letdown, I set a goal for myself. I said, all right, I want to have my first house by 30. I don't want to be a renter. That's the American dream, own a house. So I did it, but not at 30. I did it at 31. Then I ended up meeting a couple people, and started filming myself. The Food Network came out, because that didn't exist either when I started this. And everybody sat there and was like, oh, try out for this show, you're creative, this, that. So I'm like, how creative can I be? I work in a small family restaurant. Since this is North Burbank, I'm sure most of you know where the Stoppers is, right? On Boulevard East, right? That's the kind of restaurant I work in. Small little place like that. So here I am, saying to myself, can I compete against the big boys? You know, can I go against women who work in million-dollar restaurants? I don't know. I doubted myself. But then I built my confidence up. And I said, you know what? Who cares? If I can compete, that's all that matters. It doesn't matter if you win. As long as you get there. So that's what I did. I went out. I got a call. I went to New York City, and I tried out. And it's 5,000 people. That's how many people I had to compete against. 5,000. And they were only taking 80 out of 5,000. So 2 months later, after stressing and going crazy, I realized and got a phone call saying I made the top 80 list. Needless to say, yeah, I was excited, jumping down, freaking out, calling everybody I knew, you're not going to believe what happened. And I went. I went to the Food Network. And I competed against one of the most popular shows. Against a guy in Boston, people from Manhattan, and they work in $1 million to $5 million restaurants. And here I am, the little guy. And then that's what made me even want more. Because the odds were against me. Because life's a game. Every one of you guys are going to learn it. Sooner or later, you're going to realize life is just a game. Because school doesn't teach you about money. We never talk to you guys about money, how to budget money, none of that. You guys, the only thing they're going to teach you is your dreams and give you the foundations of life. It's your job, your responsibility, to make those dreams come true. So for everybody out here who doesn't have a dream or a passion, that's what you need. You need to find that first. Find out what makes you happy as an individual. don't let anybody even take your money. Because if you do, you're just going to be one of those bums that you see sitting on the corner. Those people are, you know, doing drugs, getting all banged up everywhere. Who wants that? Maybe you're depressed, you might have kids with somebody. And because you have no motivation, no dreams, then you're going to be a single parent. And ruining somebody else's life. So the dreams that you're going to find and the passion that you're going to find for yourself is very important. Don't ever let anybody take those dreams away. It's the most valuable thing you'll ever have. More valuable than any dollar, any money, anything. Because that's the only thing you're going to have in this life that nobody can ever take away. That's how important it is. Anybody here have dreams? Passions of what they want to be? What do you want to be? I'm sorry? You want to be a conductor? For Amtrak. Very nice. And what made you decide that? So you want to be able to drive them. So you love the whole Amtrak system, everything about it, right? And what about it that makes you so happy? Wait, well, my cord is stuck in my way. I want you to tell your students why you love
it. Well, because I was two, and I used to love it when I was two. I used to love how they look, how fast they go. I mean, I was just in love with training, so that's why I wanted to be a train driver today.
Beautiful. And that, you have a dream, don't ever let it go. Ever. Alright? Promise yourself that. Don't promise me. It doesn't matter if you promise me. You can lie to me. But you can't lie to yourself. So make sure you never let that go, no matter what happens. Now, when I made the Food Network, I sat there and they wanted me to cook an octopus. Anybody here familiar with the show, Jack? You guys watch it? Beautiful. Anybody actually ever see me? You saw me? Really? You saw it? Yes. Well, if anybody here has never seen it, you can always go on YouTube and look me up. Chef Anton, you have my name. You can actually watch it. But the point being, I pulled out this octopus, and I had 20 minutes with this huge, gigantic octopus put in my face. And all these crazy ingredients, some I never even saw before. And I sat there and I cooked that thing perfectly. To the point, and you'll see it if you go on YouTube and watch it. Ron Sanchez, one of the judges, told me that I was the one who cooked it perfect. Perfect, every bite was juicy and tender, the way the octopus is supposed to be made. But because I didn't come from a big place, they took away my glory that day. They actually had somebody serve unedible food go in front of me. And they ended up chopping me. Because of the fact, I didn't come from a well-recognized restaurant. Because that's how important it matters where you come from, or who you know. All they did was make that the greatest moment of my life. Because when I sat there one day and I heard that, I was depressed, I was mad, aggravated, I wanted to hurt somebody. The guy was mad, angry, mad. But then I realized and sat there and said to myself, you know what, you can't do that. You gotta think positive about it. And that's what I did. I became very positive. And I sat there and said, you know what? These are giving me the best gift of my life. And the reason why is because now I want to perfect that dish. That dish I made that day is now one of my best-selling dishes in the restaurant. And then I took that dish and I started going to other competitions. And I started winning, showing myself that was the day that was supposed to happen in my life, on my death. And now, I'm getting ready to write my first cookbook, which should be out in this fall. But more importantly, something you guys will be more excited about seeing or hearing is the fact that eventually, you all will see me again. As I just got done competing against 20,000 people throughout the entire country. I had to go to California, I had to go to Philadelphia, New York, And I've been competing for 6 months. So at this point, you guys will actually get to see me again in one of the biggest culinary competitions in the world. I will be seen in over 37 countries. And I promise, I made this and these dreams happen. Because of my determination, the respect I have for my family, knowing that it's my responsibility and nobody's going to make any success unless I do it. And the bigger the obstacle in front of you, the sweeter the glory when you conquer it. So when the door closes, remember, you need to open another door. Because every door you open and you accomplish and get into another door, that just means you're getting better and better, further and further. When you get let down, make sure you understand, being let down and a disappointment in your life is a good thing. It'll refresh you, it'll make you more hungry, more desirable to be something. So you gotta remember, these are all important facts of your life. Does anybody have any questions for me?
Yes.
I'm sorry? I didn't mean. Oh, I specialize in Italian food. Yeah, that's my specialty, that's my heritage, that's my culture. Actually, you guys might be a little young, but do you guys know who the Gideon is? Gideon? Abrasovich?
No.
Believe it or not, you guys should know about her. She is right here from Guttenberg, New Jersey. She has 12 cookbooks. She is on
me?
BBC.
Oh, no.
And she is known throughout everywhere.
I love
Channel
her.
13. Her name is Lydia. That is one of the chefs I've been told. I've also cooked, obviously, for Ron Sanchez and Mark Murphy. I've cooked for Phil Sims. For all you sports athletes, I cook on a regular basis for Randy Jacobs.
Didn't Chris Christie come to your restaurant?
Yes, I also have cooked for the governor, Chris Christie. I've made him a couple meals as well, big pasta eater. If you guys are in politics before the surgery.
There's some kids over there, questions.
Yes. Senator?
The basketball star.
No, I cook for Brandon Jacobs. The running back in the Giants. No, I don't cook for the ball. That never happened. The only basketball player I cooked for was, you guys are too young, Jason Williams. Jason Williams back in the 90s, huge. Huh?
He is a person.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. No, you play for the New York Knicks.
Carmelo.
You play for the Knicks. That's who we play for. So we have, he's got a seven question over here, I guess. How much does it cost for 3 foot dinner? 4 people? Like, how much does it cost to eat at my restaurant? Oh, to go to culinary school. What's it cost to go to culinary school?
A lot of money.
For me to make you a dish, how much would you pay? I may charge you. I would just do it because that's how much I love it. Because there's something I get from cooking, and I call it the 30-second high. The reason why it's a 30-second high is because when somebody loves it and I make somebody smile from the food that I make, it gives me such a high. And it only lasts 30 seconds. So I can do it 100 times a night and more than have a great night. Because that's how much it, that's how good it feels. Yes. I work at a restaurant, they have a restaurant called Tony's Touch of Italy in New Jersey. Yeah, we're right by a little bit of the wall. Right over there. So next time your parents come in, you guys are going to
be
or whatever. Tell them to stop in. I'm there all the time. Yes. Yes, I can't hear what he's saying. School-wise, becoming a chef, going to a trade school is a great thing. Becoming a chef, it was difficult when it came to paperwork. But I had to study and do the bookwork, stuff like that. But the actual hands-on, because I'm a visual learner, that was paid for me. I ended up going from Lawrence County Tech to the CIA, which is the Culinary Institute of America, and that's actually considered like the Harvard of schools. And education-wise, I didn't do well, but hands-on, I aced every class. The weirdest thing I ever cooked, I can tell you that off the top of my head. I actually did this thing in a restaurant for a while called Chopman. So I allowed people to tell me what they wanted me to make and challenge me. I had a 7-year-old little girl give me 3 ingredients. She wanted Sour Patch Kids, she wanted shrimp, and she wanted broccoli. Sounds pretty gross, right? I actually made a thing that I called rock shrimp, where I sat there and melted down the Sour Patch Kids, boiled them in the water. Once I was done boiling them in water, I pureed them and made them into a liquid. And I used that as the base, and I would dip the shrimp inside and I grilled them. So the shrimp actually tasted like candy. And then that's why I started calling it candy shrimp. Then I ended up putting a little spice in it, because I like spicy food. A little cayenne pepper, a little touch of it. So she actually enjoyed her broccoli and her shrimp way more. And for me to accomplish a task like that for such difficult ingredients made me feel really good. It was an awesome feeling. Just to put a smile on her. One other thing you guys should know about me, I also have become a spokesperson for St. Joe's Hospital in Paterson, New Jersey. I don't know if you guys are familiar with Paterson, New Jersey at all.
Yeah.
I actually realized the power of my food. See, I'm not smart enough to be a doctor, but my food helps save people's lives now because of everything I'm accomplishing and me giving back to the communities. So without people like me, I do a program called Cooking for Kids. I actually make money for this program at St. Joe's for NICU units. For anybody who doesn't know a NICU unit, a preemie baby, a baby was born too early. And it was a personal relationship with my friends. His baby was a preemie. So even though I'm not smart enough to be a doctor, doctors need people like me to make sure that everybody is healthy and safe and taken care of in life. So this is one of the things that you guys should be aware of that I actually deal with food. Yes?
Oh, God.
Personally, that I like to eat? It depends on my mood. Either I like pasta. Sometimes I like it very basic and simple, traditional, which is some beans and pasta with garlic and oil. And sometimes I go a little crazy with it. Sometimes I'll make something off the wall where I'm making something like a port wine sauce with like a spicy crab cake on top of the pork, wrapped in bacon, stuff like that. I'm sorry? Oh, absolutely. Like, and my mother being Italian, she wanted me to learn how to eat hot pepper as a baby. So one thing that she used to do to me is make me eat it when I was like 4. But in order to get me to eat it, she would put it on ice cream. So she put hot pepper on ice cream and I just eat that way. So you have to eat so that you appreciate the flavor of the hot pepper without actually having to deal with the heat. But then when I got older, I enjoyed it.
Oh, God. Malik, we gotta let other people ask questions.
Yeah, it's good, babe. Hold on one second. Yes. Do I make tacos? I can make tacos. I don't usually make tacos every day, but I can make tacos, yes. Do you like tacos? What kind of tacos? I'm sorry? You like meat sauce? Uh-huh. You don't like anything like a little spicier or anything like that? Sweeter? You like something? You ever have tarragon? Tarragon's a beautiful, clean taste. Something very good to eat. It's got like a nice minty flavor to it. Next. Actually, that's why I told you, I got chopped in the first round after cooking an octopus perfectly. And the best part of it was, after it aired, I started getting emails throughout the entire country, from people in South America, people in Europe, telling me I got robbed and I should have been the guy who won it. So when I saw everybody out there cheering me on, even though I didn't have my day, I knew it was I had to make sure that I had that day. I didn't want those people to be wrong. And like I I said, you guys will all see, I will have my day. Thanks. I started cooking and got in the kitchen when I was 12 years old. When I was 12 years old, I got a job at a restaurant as a busboy. When I started doing TV, I started being on TV, when did I get on there, 5 years ago?
No.
I believe, right? Five? It was 3 years ago. I did it 5 years ago, but it actually aired 3 years ago. That's the thing about TV. Like what I did, I've already done, but it's going to be over a year before everybody gets to see it. But that's the TV world. Yes? What's the best meal I've ever prepared? The best meal I ever prepared, I'll answer that question, but not fully. I actually prepared a meal where I sat there and impressed one of the top 10 chefs in the world on his personal signature dish. And when I did that, I emotionally broke down and cried. Because that's how much it meant to impress one of the best in the entire world. You know how big the world is? But that's crazy. It was one of the biggest moments of my entire life. The greatest moment in my culinary career.
And who was the chef?
You can't say.
That I can tell you. You guys will find that out.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's
not yet.
Huh?
Yes. Sailor?
I told you can't hear.
Anybody else? Shoot! Do I like hot food?
Fast food!
Fast food! Fast food, you gotta remember, food is a way of life. Your body's a temple. You know, food is the most personal thing you guys will ever have because you put it in your body. So when you think about it, you start eating the food that you were brought up on, that your mom, your grandmother made, everybody made, those are probably the best foods for you. Tomatoes. Tomatoes are one of the biggest lung cancer fighting foods out there. For anybody who has cancer in their family, anybody who may know. Garlic fights disease. Like, food saves your life if you know what foods to eat, and you have to eat it properly. Yes? I'm sorry? My biggest motivation is the one person that disappointed me more than anybody in this world. My father. My father was a good chef. He had 4 restaurants by the time he was 28. So my biggest motivation in this world, because I don't know him and he left me and abandoned me, my biggest motivation was I want to make sure I'm better than him. So he regrets it. And one day when he comes back to me, I don't need you anymore. I need you when I was a kid, not now as an adult. I want my father to regret more than anybody in this world. And I also want my mother to look at me like in a way she's never looked at me before. Just so I know she can be proud. So my mom's a farmer, so she has a very difficult time expressing. Basically, my house is a lot of yelling and screaming, because that's how foreigners are. So, when I can make her break down and cry and be proud, then I'll be happy. Until then, I'm not going to be. Next. Am I what?
Big foodie.
Do I like eating? Oh, are you kidding me? I was a fat kid. I swear to God. And if I had a picture, I'd show you. When I graduated high school, I was 250 pounds.
How do you think he played
football? I was fat. That was exactly. My nickname as a kid was Meatball. That's what they called me. And then I decided to go on a diet and lose some weight. I'm sorry? Actually, I never thought about opening up a school. What I have thought about doing is, when I get too old and work the crazy hours I work, I thought about becoming a teacher and handing down my knowledge. That's why I'm doing the cookbook. So that people from many generations will learn from me whether I'm with them or not. Yes. Sorry? I learned how to cook because of my grandparents' tradition. My parents, my family came to this country and the only thing they knew how to do was cook. They couldn't speak English. I couldn't write, I couldn't read. I couldn't couldn't do any of that. All they knew how to do was cook. So they all started getting into the food industry. And then I realized and learned what the power of food does. See, one thing that you guys, and maybe a lot of you guys don't get to experience, food brings families together. I'm sorry? On Sundays, well, back in the day, dinner was every night with your family. Now it's once a week, because times have changed. But that's how important food is for your family and your loved ones as well. Yes? Well, she already asked me, let me get the girl in the back. Here's your hand. Oh, I thought you guys. You guys will see me back on TV coming this fall. This fall, you guys can watch out, you'll see me then.
I'll let you know.
Exactly. I mean, you guys can all become fans of mine on Facebook, and the second I post it up, you guys will all be aware.
Yes.
Who do I leave my recipes to?
Francesca. Yeah.
That's his cousin.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Or what's on my recipes? Actually, the recipes that are in my book are my best-selling specials at my restaurant. My recipes, I'm putting them in a book, so I'm going to give them to the world. But no reason for me to keep them to myself. Anybody who wants to buy the book, they'll have all my recipes. All my recipes. What's the point of having a gift if you don't share it? It's like being an artist and painting a picture and never letting anybody see it. What's the point? Don't you want the world to love to see how you love and see what you did? To make it more special? Right? Exactly. Yes. All the way in the back. Yes. Stand up and scream. Okay. I'm sorry? How much does one make?
Good question.
Well, let me give you an idea. I went and worked for peanuts for many years, and I made a lot of money at all, and struggled. But I knew eventually it would all come. The most important lesson in life when it comes to money, if you decide to get a job based on money, you'll never be rich. If you worry about money, you will never be rich. If you work to be the best at what you do, the money will come. When I started, I made nothing. $200 a week. Now, I make enough money to take care of myself, take care of my girlfriend, getting ready to have a kid and everything else, and never have to worry about money. Chefs can make anywhere, depending on your skills and ability, anywhere from $50,000 a year to $250,000 a year. Some make $500,000 a year. Depends on how much are you willing to work and how hard and how good do you want to pick. Last question. I'm sorry?
Hey, somebody scream at
the weirdest thing? Yeah, that was one of the shrimp in the candy. But I'll take one more for that. Let me get right over here. Now. Have I ever cooked in different towns? With my food, yes. I worked over here in Weehawken. I worked in North Bergen. I worked in Edgewater. I worked in Oakland. I worked all over the state of New Jersey. That's how I keep developing my name. So my career, you want to work there every couple of years and then move on to another place to make your reputation more and more valuable. All right, really, last question because I'm getting yelled at. Go ahead. Food Network Studio is in Long Island City, Queens. It's in a warehouse in the middle of the project, so you never even realize it was there. It's just a big brick building. And everything is inside. Anybody ever see a studio? It's crazy. Like it's anybody who wants to be in the TV, it's an exciting life. Am I allowed to take one more?
Yeah.
I'll get your next. Can I make a homemade hot pocket? Absolutely, I can make a homemade pop a hot pocket. She wants me to remind you so you guys can see everything. You can go onto YouTube for my name, and everybody has it on the paper. Just look it up, and you guys will see a lot more about me. Facebook, you can read about my bio. You'll see where I'm from and my entire life story. And thank you very much. Thank you.